out an image. First thing you want to do is go up to Window, Workspace, and click on Photography. You should be able to see the layers and the toolbar. So the polygonal lasso tool is the second tool on the left. You're going to click on that. You want to zoom in. And you want to start clicking inside of the image, not outside, so that we don't get any of the outside sections when we're clipping it. And all this does is straight lines. So you want to make sure to create enough of them to make it look rounded. If you look at my example right here, they are not straight. They look very rounded. I get almost up to the edge, but I try not to get right onto the edge. I try to stay inside for the most part. The great thing about this tool is that it doesn't take too much to actually get started, not too much training. Some of the other tools we're gonna go over take a little bit more practice. Things like hair are not always that good with the polygonal lasso tool because there's just a lot of things that have to go around, like right here. I'm picking and choosing which parts I'm gonna actually take. I'm not gonna take those flyaway hairs. Now the one thing you don't want to do with a polygonal lasso tool is double click. I'll show you after I finish this selection what happens if you double click, because sometimes we're in a rush and we're doing multiple lines. And if we double click, what's going to happen is it's going to close. But I'm going to show you how that happens. And if it happens by mistake, there's ways to fix it. But more practice with this will help you not to have that for the next time. Especially after going through so many clicks, you're just going to be like, okay, I'm never going to do that again. So you see the nose is rounded, but I'm using straight lines to get a rounded corner right here. Things like facial feature, I tend to take more time with just because I know it's very important to the final image. And you're actually able to use the same exact file that I'm using. It's going to be called poly.jpg, and you guys will get a link to it. And again, rounded corner right here. So I'm just trying to stay still a little bit inside of the image so that I don't get any of the background, but I'm making smaller lines to make that rounded corner. I want to make sure that I include that shoulder. Sometimes when you're zoomed in so much, you forget what part is shirt and what part is background. I did take off a little bit of that shoulder, but I see that it's a little bit fuzzy right here. Now, with the polygonal lasso tool, once you get to the end, you want to actually close it off, right? I'm clicking underneath. This is actually not even part of the image. When I click here, take a look at what happens. It changes. My cursor looks like the polygonal lasso tool, but at the end, it has that full circle icon pop up. When I click on it, the marching ants will pop up. That tells me that my selection is created. And then on the layers, I want to click right here on the Japan flag to make my selection. And that's it. Let me just show you what happens when you double click by mistake. Let's say I was selecting something here. Click, 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 right? I'm taking all my time. If I double click, it closes it off for me, which is not what I want in the middle of me going around the whole thing. Now you can see there are some parts that probably should be edited a little bit, but for the most part, it does an okay job. With backgrounds that are similar to the skin color or to what it is that you're clipping, it's actually pretty good. If you look at the shirt itself, because the background is similar to it, it did an okay job.